Hello, welcome to Kubernetes admission controllers from scratch. I'm going to whack an ish on there because I can't teach you all of the underlying technologies surrounding it. So there's going to be a little bit of what I'm not going to show you and then a little bit of what we are going to learn. It is an instruct workshop, so it kind of like should guide you through what we're going to do without too much interaction. However, if you get stuck, these are my lovely and talented proctors. This is Matt Johnson and Angela Gizzi. I've been saying it wrong the whole time. My name's Steve Giguere. Do you want to introduce me? Do I say anything about who you are? No, great. Anonymous is, that's what security is all about. If you know what admission controllers are, great. Hands up if you know what they are already. You're like, cool, I just want to learn how to make one. That's most of you. It's essentially a very simple Kubernetes webhook that intercepts any request to instantiate or make something persistent within etcd and then checks it to make sure it is doing something. Or there's a lot of different types of admission controllers that are built into Kubernetes. We're not going to talk about all of them. We're only really going to talk about validating admission controllers. This is what some people consider the last line of defense to make sure you haven't done something absolutely horrendous. It should never be your first line of defense. And we're going to talk a little bit about consistency of policy as code as a takeaway of from this, because ideally you've done everything by the time you get to an admission controller, and it's just making sure that you're not changing or manually doing something that's going to absolutely shoot you in the foot. Just as a little bit of a reminder, the two types of dynamic admission controllers are validating and mutating. The validating is the one I just mentioned. It passes an admission review request to validate what it is, and that's encapsulating the object you're trying to persist. And as part of this workshop, we're going to see what that looks like. And that was one of the most important pieces that I had to get through. A little bit of background. The reason this workshop exists is because I had to write an admission controller for the open source project I work on, which is called Chekhov. It's a policy engine written in Python. And they asked if we could have an admission control. I thought, no problem. So I went online looking for information on how to write one, and there is hardly anything really. There's no description of the admission review object anywhere in the documentation. So I thought, oh, good God. All right. So this is me documenting what I did and then turning it into a workshop for you. Mutating admission controllers, finger in the air as to whether I agree with them or not. I don't think you should ever mutate anything on its way in. Sometimes you need to, but I think it's just generally a bad security practice. And don't argue with me after it's over. The anatomy of it is very simple. There's an API handler. It authenticates to make sure you're even allowed to. The mutating admission controllers will modify whatever you're doing. Then once the schema is validated and just make sure it's not total nonsense, it goes to the validating admission controller, and we're going to write that little webhook code implementation piece together today. And if it is acceptable, it becomes persistent in your cluster. I stole this diagram from Sysdig. Thanks very much, Sysdig, for that. What is going to be in our container today? We're going to be using a bunch of technologies that I'm not going to necessarily teach you how they work, but we're going to kind of see a demonstration of what they do. We're going to use the Gunicorn, I don't know, WSGI as a conductor for the format of the admission control. We're going to make a Python Flask application. I will provide a lot of little frameworks that will just have big gaps in them, and that's what we're going to fill in. I'm not going to say, here's a blank screen, write your Python webhook from nothing. Not that mean. We'll deal with the manifest, submission configuration, the deployment. We'll generate some certs. And we'll create the service manually using kubectl. All of this will be provided to you via instruct. The link for instruct, I have put it in so many places because I had no idea how to convey it to you all when you're all sitting there with, you know, 20 different laptops. We're also going to use this. If you've ever seen this before, hands up if you know it. It's awesome. It's a totally anonymous, ephemeral registry. You don't need authentication. You can push images and pull, and we're going to use it today, and it just put a time limit on it based on the tag, and you're going to see how that works. It's really good for both workshops and capture the flags. Keep that in mind. Should you be in a capture the flag in the near future, it might help you solve some problems. Not busting control plane on that at all. What we won't cover today, the vast list of existing admission controllers. I'm not going to get into the new alpha feature for validating admission controllers that comes with Kubernetes 1.2.6 in common expression language, because it's not 100% totally functional. So it would be a disaster. K8 come to the next SecureCon and I'll do that one. Not going to get into how to create a Flask application, but I will provide you a basic framework and you will learn from it. You don't need deep knowledge of Kubernetes manifests. We either provide you with it or if it's generatable, because some you can from kubectl, just do a dry run and generate what you want. If it's possible, I do that. The admission configuration, there's no way to generate it. So I've given you the shape of it. And I'm not going to go too deep on kubectl. All commands are provided with an explanation. You can cut and paste. You can be super lazy on this, or you could deep dive as much as you want. Prerequisites. You do need some way to get access to a terminal. Laptops, I see most people have that, which is awesome. The Kubernetes cluster will be provided. It's just a single node. I will ask you to be kind to the Kubernetes cluster and be kind to the VM that you get provided by an instruct, because it looks like you kind of have root access to it. I don't know, so don't mess around. And you need the instruct workshop invitation. So there's many ways to get access to it. If you're on the CNCF Slack, there is a channel now called CNSC AC Workshop. You can go to the channel, you can join it, you can ask questions via the channel, I'll be watching it, and the link is the first thing that's posted in that channel. You just click it and boom, you're gonna have your invite. It will ask you for your name and email. That is only so I can tell via the dashboard who you are. I'm not gonna use your email for anything evil. It's there. I tried doing a workshop with it anonymous, and all of the workshops just had squiggly anonymous. So say you asked me and you had a problem and you said, I can't log into where you are to fix it because I don't know who you are. You're just some random code. So we decided to do it that way, for which I apologize. So the QR code does it, the link there. If you go to Sketch, the slides are there and the link is in the slides. If you go to Sketch and you find my profile, into my profile, there's a website, it's the invite. So there's like five ways to get this invite. One of them should work, I hope. I think I pre-started something like 20 VMs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay, so slightly over 20, so some of you may have to wait 3 minutes when you first go in, because that's how long it takes to start. Those of you who are impatient will be rewarded, because there should be some hot VMs ready to roll. Is there anything afterwards? Takeaways. What I'm hoping you get out of this is admission controllers are good. That's good. The basics of how they work under the covers. I shouldn't say that. Under the hood. That sounds that's less weird. How to build a basic admission controller. What a secure Kubernetes manifest looks like. There's some additional takeaways in terms of security. I hand you a deployment, but it's actually a deployment that passes almost every possible, whether it be OPA or Python or Kiverno, it will pass everything. Because if you're going to build an admission controller that's checking, you shouldn't be a hypocrite. You should actually be using a secure deployment in the first place. And it's actually really hard to make one of those. So I've kind of handed you an almost finished deployment that does all the good things. Taking it to the next level as a policy as code engine. The last step, we actually add the open source project that I'm working on. And as is Matt back there, he is a co-author and co-contributor to Chekhov. We're going to add that as the last step, and you can suddenly get a policy engine with thousands of rules and go from zero to hero really fast. And then talk a little bit about policy consistency, because the reason we created the admission control in the first place is because we had our policy engine embedded into the IDE. It works in VS Code, and it was all great, but we didn't have anything at the end. So we just tried to make the whole thing consistent, and this is what it came from. The complete, super done version of this is called Wharf. I worked with a startup now acquired called Bridgecrew. There's a Star Trek theme, and if you caught onto that, the open source is called Chekhov, the admission controller is called Wharf, Chief Security. You see what I'm doing there? All right. You can go check that out. If you want to see like what the result of this thing is, but amped up, you can go check that out under Bridgecrew, and we can do it. So I think we're ready to go. Forget that. Hands up if you cannot get the link. Hands up if you can get the link, just so I know you're all good. All right, everyone's moving. If everything seems good and you've got it started, excellent. If you want to ask questions, feel free. It should be kind of a DIY. The fastest person who did it, by the way, both Angela and Matt did it. Angela's in kind of our marketing guru. No real Kubernetes experience. Did it in about the time allotted. Matt knows a ton about Kubernetes, got it done in about 40 minutes, and barely read anything. So I figure, depending on what you can do, you should be able to get this done pretty quick. Cool? All right. Away. I'm going to put it up on the screen, but you don't have to talk to me unless you really need help. You can ask questions just live or via the Slack. And go. Oh, something I should note. I didn't turn off this, the skip to, because I can, but I thought, well, if you just decide whatever, you can jump. The workshop will be available for a couple days after, so once you get started, you can come back to it. Or if you screw up an exit for some reason and you were like at level four, you can jump skip to, and I've got scripted backends that actually does all the thing for you and puts all the things in place. You can kind of jump around. You could cheat to your heart's content, essentially. And yes, it is competitive. There is a leaderboard. I am watching. just based on that, the biggest problem anybody ever had doing this was cutting and pasting, particularly with YAML indenting. So double check if something goes wrong. That's generally why. The code editor does a good version of highlighting indenting problems. So if you see a red squiggle, you've done something wrong. I probably should point out that the sign outside the door says the workshop goes till 11:35. That is incorrect. It goes until 12:25. The screen was wrong. So just in case you're wondering, you're expecting it to end right now. It's never going to end.
who's winning, Steve? It's not a competition, but it is. Josh is winning.
Yeah, you're killing it.
Although people are catching up, so there's time left yet.
Yeah, three and four are the hardest, I think. So if you pass that, you're on the home stretch.
There's no real prizes. It's just pride.
There is like stickers and junk in the back corner. If you like stickers, then when you're done, you can feel free. And pins.
And a snazzy pen.
And snazzy pens. Yeah.
Is everyone doing okay? Does anyone need a hand? No? All good? Awesome.
You can tell Matt's bored. Most of you are probably past it, but it would notice that when the Docker build goes, there's a couple of red warnings. I tried to get rid of as many warnings as I could, but then I was like, oh, gosh, they're all fine. They're just warnings for certain things missing in the container. V2 of this, I'll get rid of all the warnings. The other thing was there was a question about the label that gets added to the namespace and what that, why that's there and why it's blocking. I do mention it in the text. I do mention it as well at the very end of the workshop. Like a quick key takeaway is that having a label you can add to a namespace to make the entire namespace ignored. I did not do that when I first wrote this, and I shut down all of the kube system stuff by accident. So not only do you want to add it to your own admission controller namespace, you would actually add it to all the kube star just to make sure you don't actually kill off your entire infrastructure by accident. We don't have a prize for finishing first, but if you just want to, you know, look over and make them feel uncomfortable, they're leaving. Well done. 30 minutes is about the fastest Matt did it, and Matt actually helped write the thing. One thing before you go, and I'll say it to you and I'll say it to everybody else, there is an AC workshop in Git under my IDE Eurogig. That's where it gets cloned from, but I deleted the .git in the VM. So if you wanted to, you could set the config and push it into your own Git so you have it, like, and the VM will be alive for another day. So you can do it whenever. Cool? All right, awesome. If you get to the very end, I have worded something badly, if you happen to get there. You can sort of see on the screen, there's a, this is not what it looks like to you, but this is what the text looks like. This if result equals equals true. I don't want this to go here. I want it to go after the else here. I worded that badly, so do not, I will change it in future workshops. We have 3 minutes until we'll be violently ejected from the room by the police. So I'm going to say a few wrap-up things. First one, you can just keep doing this. This is a good venue for you to ask questions if something goes wrong, but I'll still be on the Slack during the day if you have a problem, if you're not done. If you do get done, awesome. The VM I just checked, I thought I set it up for a day. I set it up for 3 days. That's what happens when Instruct gives you the this particular workshop without paying for it, is I abuse the resources. So you will have it for a few more days if you want to play with it or redo it or copy it. As I said earlier, there's no .git, so if you want to do a git config and push a result and then you have it for later, awesome. If you didn't get to the end, there's a feedback form that Angela's added just to see if you want to learn more about open source projects that we do, fill it in. If you don't, it's optional. You could just click check and skip the whole thing, but please do, because we like to inform you. There's swag at the back, and if you want to see what like the end is, you can go to GitHub Bridgecrew.io wharf, and this was where this went after. This is like how I built the first prototype, and then from there we've expanded it out. You'll see very similar Kubernetes manifests, services, all of this stuff is here, looking very similar to what you built. It's just you'll find the app is a little bit more, you know, decked out a little bit, and there's a lot more going on inside the wharf.py. So if you kind of just want to see how to extend it, go check it out. Otherwise, I think, any other words of wisdom that I missed, Angela or Matt, or are we good?
Thanks for coming, and thanks to Instruct for hosting our workshop stuff.
Yeah, big shout out. It's really easy. If you're not using Instruct, it's like super duper easy to make workshops. I'm super happy. I was like plugging away at this thing, like going, how on earth am I gonna do this and distribute it? But it's easy. Otherwise, I think I just chewed up the last 3 minutes. We have 1 minute to get out. Thanks.